Hey guys, Dylan from the Geek Door here, and today I'll be bringing you my reaction to RWBY Volume 9 Episode 2, titled Altercation at an Auspicious Auction. Now, at the point of recording this, Crunchyroll does have the title up for this episode. It also has the one for last episode, which was A Place of Peculiar Concern. But the synopsis isn't really anything. It just says, in which Team RWBY gets more than they bartered for. Now, looking at the time for this episode, which is 17 minutes, same as the last episode, a little concerned about that. However, we also haven't seen the first, 6 minutes of this episode, so maybe nothing to be concerned about. But yeah. Anyway, let's get this started in 3, 2, 1, go. Why did it? I don't know why it switched over scenes when I clicked that, but yeah, so, something I noticed after recording the first episode is, well, it didn't get copyright claimed like it normally does. Yeah, so, normally when recording off of the Rooster Teeth site, it'll get copyright claimed within the first couple hours, and then you'll just have to put in a dispute and everything. It'll be out by the next weekend. Yeah, with Crunchyroll and their year-long premiere service, there was nothing. Weird. I am still feeling pretty vindicated that that is a Jekyll. That's some interesting music.
So are we just gonna stand around thinking about this in silence, or?
I know this place is weird, but a fairy tale? I mean, that's impossible.
Yeah, that's fair.
What we've seen is improbable, but that doesn't mean we're in an actual fairy tale. Are we seriously entertaining this?
Do you have a better explanation for what's going on?
Oh, great. There's even more segments than we initially thought.
We fell from the sky. RWBY made friends with a tiny mouse. Friends! Blake and I got caught by killer vines. And, you got your arm stolen by a... What was it that you said?
A talking raccoon riding on a purple wagon filled with trash.
Right.
Yes. That. Okay. I see your point of view. I am going to go over here now. Of course it's thriving over
here. Oh,
wise. As crazy as it sounds, something about this is familiar.
The girl who fell through the world. I think we're in the ever after.
Blake, that world is make-believe. It was just part of a story we all read as kids.
It's not make-believe. It's where I live.
Can you tell us more about it? Have you ever heard the name Alex?
An Alex? Is that a purpose?
No. In the story, Alex fell from the sky and met with the hunter mice. Got trapped in vines, bought a jabberwocker, and got her knife stolen by a talking raccoon.
Yeah, and then she beat the Red King at a board game, met the curious cat, the rusted knight, and finally got out through
the tree.
Okay, so it's a king.
So what now? Do we go to the tree, look for Alex, Yang's arm? RWBY, you're still missing Crescent Rose.
I'll bet the Jinxie Peddler has it.
Who?
The Jinxie Peddler? That's the only talking raccoon I know.
I can't. Do you know where he might be?
Of course. I'll lead the way.
Right, you're gonna fall asleep. Yep.
So the town is just ahead, right? I've been thinking. Aww. If we're going to go to this town, we need to be careful. Alex didn't know their customs and ended up starting a war among the townsfolk. Trouble followed her everywhere she went.
Well, yeah, but she was kind of a mean person, right? She lied and cheated her way through most of the book.
She was trying to survive. The morals of those old stories are so simplistic.
Either way, we need to tread lightly.
The town's just up ahead. The Jinxie Peddler always stops by our village before he goes to town.
Do they steal stuff from you guys too?
Steal? Never. They just take the things we're not looking at. Fair's fair.
No, that's stealing.
Sounds like a legitimate business person. How did they manage to steal your arm anyway?
I was knocked out from the fall. When I came to, that sneaky raccoon had already grabbed my arm and ran off before I could stop him.
So would you say he caught you unarmed?
How disarming.
I guess we'll have to catch this.
About time.
For what?
Nothing.
Don't worry. We'll find a way out of here, and then we'll go back home. Weiss?
It's all gone. There's nothing left for me to go back to. Just like Beacon.
You did the best you could for Atlas, Weiss.
But it wasn't enough. We hatched a crazy plan that put a whole kingdom at risk, and we don't even know if we saved the relics from...
You didn't.
Maybe John and Winter were able to get them out. Despite everything. Despite us. I know that Penny... I know that was a lot to hear.
And there's the rain again.
So this is the entrance to the other acre, you called it?
Yep. All we do is cross the bridge, and we'll be, well, wherever over there is.
You don't know?
Nope. Never been this far from home.
Oh, maybe
you take
should
one
go
more
back?
Step on the furthest from the shire I've ever back. Been.
Maybe I'll live by this bridge.
I'll handle this.
Building a house, my very first house. Gonna find my purpose in my best house.
Would you like to come with us?
Yeah, that's probably for the best.
Just act like you belong, everybody.
I've always wanted to be long, but I'm still just small.
There it is. So what's the strategy? Just start roughing them up or what?
Possibly not the best idea.
Alex had to barter with Jinxie for her dagger.
Yeah, I think I'd rather hit him.
Welcome, one and all!
He's adorable!
And a lot older than I remember from the book.
I am Jinxie, and these are the finest treasures of the Acre!
I don't see my arm. All of Jinxie's treasures are just other items in disguise, so that people think they're buying something extremely valuable.
Okay. So, which one is Yang's arm?
What does your heart tell you? That's how Alex knew.
I mean, that one looks roughly arm-sized-ish.
And it's the right colors and everything.
RWBY, there's something about that one.
First item! The diamond-studded rabbit! You! Jinxies!
How are we going to bid without any money?
I don't think there's any money in the ever after. Jinxie just names whatever price he wants.
What did Jinxie want from Alex?
Her saddest memory. And her happiest.
Sold for a hug.
Hugs are very valuable.
Maybe this won't be so bad after all.
Second item, a golden scepter. The bidding starts at...
No, I was the first one to...
Knowing what it is to feel loved. A fair price for some, I'd say.
Knowing what it's like to feel loved. By royal decree.
Sold!
Wait, that's my arm!
Whatever it is, it's royal property now. No price is too high for His Majesty's birthday.
First item, the Jade Marionette.
We tried it your way, Blake.
No!
RWBY, what are you doing?
Bidding starts at enough hope to fill this jar.
Enough hope.
You don't have enough, do you? Why, you little rat! Leave that alone! You can't touch it until the deal is done!
Huh?
Spinny sword. Huh? It's not a full-ass mouse!
I'm going for it.
Fair's fair.
I got it. RWBY, come on.
It's just not hurrying or anything. Oh, he got his hug back.
Those people take auctions very seriously. High five? High five? We're doing the same thing Alex did. We're ruining everything.
That's your biggest concern right now?
I've read so many stories. I never thought I'd be the moral of one. RWBY?
I couldn't explain why, but I was drawn to it. Great. Now it's raining on just us. That's it. We're getting out of this nightmare. Alex went to the tree, right? Let's go.
I don't think it's gonna work like that.
in the book.
We are not in a book. And even if we were, we know how it ends. Right over there.
And she's coming in from the left of the screen.
To the tree that way.
Well, then what do we do now? We've got my arm, but we still don't have Crescent Road or the slightest idea.
What's really the mood this episode?
This way! Somebody's sad! I'd be sad too if I ruined the royal birthday.
These guys again.
Blake, what did Alex do next?
She went to the Crimson Castle and beat the Red King in his own game.
You treasonous birthday ruiners!
Okay.
We want to go to the birthday party.
Well, too bad, because we're going to... Yes. That's where we're taking you, as prisoners, for stealing royal property.
What if I offered you something better? The weapon of a powerful... warrior.
Ooh, go on.
Not just a powerful warrior. The most powerful to ever live. She was touched by magic. She gave her life for thousands. She took a message of hope to the stars. And she saw the world through better eyes. Take us to the royal birthday and allow us to present this most precious gift.
Yes, by royal decree. Come on, men. You heard her. We've got a birthday to celebrate.
So they do flat out say when someone's sad that it rains.
Look, we may not know exactly what's going on. But for whatever reason, this place is putting us on a similar path as a book we all read as kids. I say we follow it. And stop pretending we know what we're doing.
That was an interesting episode. I don't know who voiced the toy sword. Okay, so there were three different voices for the toy soldiers. There was Nick Kramer, Cody Hawkins, and Caden. Huh. Did not pick that voice. Okay, that was a... It's an interesting episode. Much more bleak than the last one. But it did have its humorous moments. So I've gotta ask, what was the point of Jinxy? Like, obviously assuming it's gonna come back, like that, the raccoon's gotta come back. Especially since it, you know, stole a whole living mouse. And, sold it to someone. Plus, it was asking for abstract concepts for physical items, like, well, a hug for a mouse that's not really abstract, but what it's like to feel loved and enough hope to fill a jar, like how can you even really barter with those things? And as he called out, Ruby's got no hope left. Like, every plan she's ever made to make the world a better place has gone down the drain. And even the things that she thought were still there aren't there anymore. Like, you can see why she doesn't have any hope. And you can also... there's also the fact that those abstract concepts are extremely related to the object that he was selling as well. Enough hope to fill a jar. Penny was literally a beacon of hope for the last two volumes. Like, what it means to feel loved is Yang literally risked her body, literally risked her own body and health to save Blake. And it resulted in her getting that arm. Like, it's related to the object that he was selling. Yet, how could he possibly have known that? And... Also, I do like how Weiss said, it's about time, when Blake and Yang were having their moment. And RWBY's just too caught up in everything to see the happiness that was right in front of her. The soldiers, they're as comical as I was expecting. But... No, they were even more comical than I was expecting. It really is Wonderland. I wasn't expecting their story to be so similar to the girl who fell through the world, though. Like, it's literally saying everything that we know to happen in this season. Though it did leave out a couple other things, like... fell from the sky, met the warrior mice, got ensnared by vines, had something stolen from the raccoon and got it back, went to see the king and beat him at his own game, met the rusted knight, made their way to the tree. Like, those are things we know happen already, like, so the fact that it's going beat for beat is... very interesting. And the fact that they would say the entire story in the second episode also raises questions as to what's going to deviate from the story. Anyway, well, this episode once again has invalidated some of my theories. And ironically, it's once again the theory that's coming out before this episode airs. I meant to have the both of my theory videos out before the first episode came to the public, but the second one, specifically what the story of the Ever After is going to be, is not quite... well, it's actually very similar to what happened, but... yeah, it's got some things wrong in there. But I guess if you want, you just have to watch that. I'll link it up in the corner. And with that being said, I'll catch you in the next one.